believe that the bishop is not following his duties as our good shepherd.
Tonight, some churchgoers on Sanibel are calling on their bishop to fire their priest.
We have told you about this priest before right here on ABC 7. More than a week ago, Joseph Gates was arrested for a DUI. And that's part of the reason the parishioners want him gone, but that's not all of it. It is your big story tonight. Thanks for watching. I'm Jeff Butera.
Hi, I'm Krista Fogelsong. ABC 7's Alex Howard talked to that group tonight who say they want him out, and they've wanted him out since he got the position.
Well, just this morning, a group calling themselves the Parishioners for Justice of the St. Isabel Parish sent this open letter to Bishop Frank DeWayne of the Diocese of Venice. They're asking him for him to remove Gates as priest. But problems with St. Isabel's leadership goes back to their previous priest, Reverend Christopher Senk, who was removed in 2017 after being accused of financially exploiting an ailing parishioner.
I don't believe he has done so in the past. This is a perfect opportunity for him to show us that he does care.
Parishioners are used to seeing Father Gates in his frock, but instead, this is the image burned into their minds, a mugshot, arrested for DUI.
I would say it's almost unheard of. And it doesn't just have to be a priest, it could be anybody that's arrested on a DUI and incarcerated.
Gates was arrested on August 3rd for DUI, on a Saturday night while driving with the church's business manager, back from a personal social engagement. Gates returned to Mass this past Sunday.
The priest was on the altar, with no apologies, no message of any kind.
Angering parishioners into action. Today, calling on the bishop to fire him. But their calls could be falling on deaf ears. This isn't the first time they faced leadership problems in the pews. In 2017, the previous pastor, Christopher Senk, was placed on administrative leave for allegedly financially exploiting a sick woman.
Our pastor was never arrested, was never incarcerated.
A charge he was eventually cleared of by former Lee County Sheriff Mike Scott.
Nevertheless, the bishop sought to have him removed and defrocked as a priest.
Despite parishioners' calls to reinstate Senk, Gates was named as the parish's priest 2 years ago. And Gates' DUI charge now reopens that old wound.
To the bishop, I would say that he is tone deaf when it comes to the message from the parishioners to him about this priest and about our parish and about our pastor.
As for the diocese, they say the matter is pending before they take action.
And I also reached out to Reverend Joseph Gates' attorney for comment, but I didn't hear back tonight. As for Gates, he remains as acting priest for the parish while Senk is on paid leave, awaiting action from the Vatican. Live in studio, Alex Howard, ABC 7.